Another caravan of migrants making its way toward our southern border. Video from southern Mexico showing more than 2,000 people, mostly from Central America, storming through Mexican security forces who'd set up a blockade to try to stop the caravan. This, as new Border Patrol numbers show more than 1.7 million migrant encounters in fiscal year 2021, a record number. Joining us now, former acting ICE director Tom Homan. He is also a Fox News contributor. Tom, thank you so much for being here. I mentioned that number. You take issue with that figure reported by CBP, 1.7 million migrant encounters. Why do you believe it's higher?
Well, if you look at the CBP website, they got 1.9 enforcement actions. They're not counting the aliens that show up at a port of entry. They all don't cross the border and turn themselves over to the Border Patrol. They do go to port of entry and turn themselves over to CBP officers, and they're not counting that number in those figures. But if you go back 10, 15 years ago, they used to count the number on one. So that 1.9, they don't want to compare that to historical figures because it's already the worst ever historically. But the 1.9 would be a far worse story. So, you know, even 1.7 is a historic figure. But I'm just saying, if you look at the data, it's really 1.9.
And as we see this new caravan that is now, according to our reporting, more organized, they can register with QR codes, et cetera. We are also hearing from non-border state Governor Jim Justice of West Virginia on the impacts he has seen. Take a listen.
As we have seen an immediate uptick from the standpoint of deaths coming from drugs, and it is a direct correlation with what is happening at the border. Now, just imagine how far we are from the border, and a lot of people would think, well, we're protected and everything, but we have seen an immediate uptick.
Tom, this is very much not just a border issue.
No, it's not. And I was in Arizona a few months ago with about 100 sheriffs from throughout the country. They're all feeling the effects of the border. It just fentanyl alone. There's been enough fentanyl that crossed that border illegally that's killed over 90,000 young people in this country. And the DEA, Drug Enforcement Administration, has been clear that 95% of that fentanyl comes across the southwest border. And the reason that fentanyl is getting across the border not being apprehended is because Border Patrol has got about 50%, 40 to 50% of their manpower has been taken off the line to process these large groups. It leaves large portions of the border unguarded. For instance, when they had 12,000-15,000 Haitians under the bridge, they pulled all border assets out of the Del Rio sector into that area, which left 224 miles of border unguarded. Not a single Border Patrol agent there. So this surge is just not an immigration issue. It's a drug issue. It's a criminal aliens coming across. Possible terrorists could be coming across. You know, Border Patrol arrested 14 people on the FBI screening database. That's what they arrested. So how many bad people came in that 400,000 that got away?
Right, and the Biden administration says what we're seeing here is a result of root causes in these home countries of these migrants, poverty, corruption, and violence. But then also we've seen in Bill Malusian's reporting that there are people in that caravan who are saying they're coming here specifically because of Biden. If the president went to the border, changed his message a little bit, do you think that would have any impact here?
First of all, the root causes, that's a false narrative. Where were the root causes in FY19 when President Trump had the illegal immigration down 82%. Where are the root causes then? 83% decline in illegal immigration. The root causes of the Oval Office, the promises he made, the executive orders he signed, getting rid of all the programs that worked in the Trump administration, that's the cause. I mean, the president himself during the campaign says, I'm going to put a moratorium on deportations. I'm going to award amnesty and DACA. I'm going to shut down immigration detention. And I'm going to get free health care. When he made those type of promises, the whole world listened. And who wouldn't want to come to the greatest country in the world to receive those types of benefits? So this is President Biden and his immigration policies that are causing a crisis. The president of Guatemala has said it. President Honduras has said it. Even the president of Mexico has come out and said, the Biden policies are causing the surge.
We will continue to follow this. Tom Homan, thank you so much for being here today. Have a good one.
Thanks for having me.
I'm Steve Ducey.
I'm Brian Kilmeade.
And I'm Ainsley Earhart. And click here to subscribe to the Fox News YouTube page to catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis.